What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo from the BTNHD, and you and me are going to learn how to install VM backup and replication version 10 within a server environment. So let's get right into it. Okay, so today is all about VM, and the reason why I am dealing with VM with you guys is that I'm actually testing it out for my 9-to-5 job to see if it's a good application to back up my virtual machines, right? So first things first, on the desktop, I'm going to right-click on the start menu, go to run, and from here, I'm going to type in WinVer, hit OK, and I'm running everything within a Server 2019 environment, right? This is a virtual machine within a Hyper-V environment. So first thing that we need to do is mount our VM backup and replication 10 CD, DVD, ISO, whatever you have, right? You are able to extract the ISO to a folder and double click on the exe file. Do it that route. It's up to you. We are going to right click and we are going to execute, and you get the nice little wizard, and right there, there goes the option, right? Click on install, but CPU does not meet the requirements. You need at least two processors for this to work. Trying to get a little cheap with the virtual machine, and I only gave it one processor. So it's super simple. Shut down your machine. Go inside properties, within properties, bump up the virtual processor to 2. Apply it, okay, restart it again, remount the ISO, start it again, execute the setup file, and you get this again, right? Click on install. Once you click on install, it's going to say, please wait, and you get this. Awesome. You need to accept the license and terms. You got 2 check marks. If you don't check them off, you can't go next, so click on next. From here, you need to browse for your license to get the enterprise version. If not, you are able to just install the community edition. So click next from there. I left everything as the default, which is going to drop it inside the C drive. Click next. One of the cool things that I like about this installation is that it's missing stuff, and it's going to retrieve it and install it for us. Awesome. So click on install. It's going to start installing all the missing features. Once it's done, you're going to get all green check marks, which is a good thing. Click on next. And if you want, you are able to check, let me specify different settings. If not, leave everything as is. Click install. It's going to start installing everything. And eventually you're going to get this. This is always a good thing. And then click on finish. And then you're able to exit out of that. And on your desktop, you get a nice little icon. And if you double click on that icon, it's going to launch this. You're going to leave everything as the default and just click on connect. You get a nice little thing right here. It's connecting. And eventually, it's going to load up. How easy is that? And that's it, guys. Hopefully, you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure to hit that thumbs up. Don't forget about smashing that subscribe button. And also hit that notification bell to get the latest and greatest from this guy. And I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.